just share one or two quick things on Lord Ganesha. There is so much. But maybe when there's a Ganesha, we could talk more. Ganesha Baba, you have decapitation. The head was cut off. We're not going to the story. Elephant head was placed. The human is the microcosm, the elephant, the macrocosm. Simple but big words, man must live in harmony with nature. Devotees, why do we have environmental pollution? Pollution in the air, on the land, and in the water. Because man's mind has become polluted. When I go for river life, I pelt the plate, I pelt the bone. Sorry, but I will help you. Why care? Litter the place. I drive it, I don't drink it, whatever. I pelt the bone. And we were told we about any son, about the mother. Bout any water, Gandama. Go back to these practices, devotees. So Ganesh Baba remind us of our responsibility for a better environment. Hindus and Hinduism will always preach about the full set of environmentalists on the face of this earth. Long time when mother said, don't kick the broom boy, don't throw down salt boy, don't fail the sun and brush the teeth and spit boy. What mother was telling you, respect the sun, respect the earth, and respect everything on this earth. And they say, lad, them old lady and them boy, what are them old lady and them boy? They don't understand what our mother was saying to us and father was saying to us. Devotees, all from Lord Ganesh. I have to move on. When their head was removed and an elephant head was placed, what did that tell you? Organ transplant. Isn't that a medical fact? Transplantation of the kidney. One gone, they get the next one. Heart transplant. This was head transplant. Devotees. Again, we see the use of the body. There was a great sage called Dadhichi. He took out a bone, a rib, to make a weapon to destroy demonic forces. The sages cut their hands and give blood as taps for our. Devotees. I am not telling you what to do, but I'm suggesting and you decide what you will do. There is not what we call harvesting of human organs. It's a law. And before I die, I sign that agreement that when I die, if there's anybody who needs my eye or needs an eye, anybody who needs my heart, if it is good, anybody who needs my kidney, if it is good, then take it and give it to them. Some people say, nah, God send me back my heart and my kidney, and maybe God will have no heart and kidney. And then this is stupid forever. Hey, smarty, when they put you in the fire and they burn you, where your heart and where your organ gone? I saw like a quarrel. Yeah. Devotees, we think in a real wrong side of something. Our religion allows for the giving of blood, and there is a serious shortage of blood. And anything I tell you to do, I'm doing it because I'm a blood donor too. I used to give blood. I know how much I give. I know it's gone, but that doesn't matter. You're healthy, you're strong, somebody's sick, somebody may be in an accident. They want blood. Oh, go and get some blood now. That is down. Our religion says, Satyam, Satyam, Daya, down. Give charity. Charity isn't just money, not clothing, only food, you know. If you give up yourself, you give some blood. You know what a great gift that is, devotees? This is where religion becomes so much so relevant to all of us. That's why you can't touch it, you can't beat it. The devotees, organ transplant, giving of blood. Interesting. Ganesh had the elephant head, Ganesh had one. The elephant is a vegetarian. You have to choose what you want to eat. Devotees, but the best type of diet, if one wants to be truly spiritual, is vegetarianism. You get all the protein in the dal. I don't care if you call your dal water, this and that. They say, call me that. I want to see the muscle and the kind of strength I have to run. I play cricket ball over the boundary. They say, nah boy, young Indian habit boy. I say, they get that, they actually get that from, say, dal boy. Go drink dal. And pick up gobar. You know gobar? Lift up gobar and chew it over a thingy pen. Milk cow, chung chai, chung chai. Then you go get strength, then you get power devotees. People don't understand. We have everything, my dear brother and sister. And we throw it away. We don't appreciate it. Devotees. If a young Guruji asks a young man, he says, Beta, you want to get strong? He say, yeah. He say, why? He said, I'm feeling all the trouble. I'm going to take nursery. If I get strong, I'll get him out of the blow. He said, I hear what? You know how to get strong? He said, no. Tell me now. He said, look at the elephant. Is it strong or is it weak? He said, elephant, real powerful. When an elephant up, every man run. He said, okay, he said, are you strong like an elephant or anything around me? He said, yes. He said, well, hear what? If you want to be strong as an elephant, will you eat the elephant? Or will you eat what the elephant eats? And the elephant is eat grass. You hear me? Think about it, devotees. Think about it. As I eat it, so I think it. As I think it, so I act it. As I act it, so I become it. So I am the product of what I eat and what I think. What am I eating? What am I thinking? You have to answer. And you won't even let you know, we'll talk now. Habits are formed and taste is acquired. How they got the taste, they have to go quack, quack, quack all about. Because we gave it to them. We could bring that taste. But the choice is ours. Choice is ours. Devotees. We can go on. Galit Baba represents the Muladhara chapter. It's the base energy center. From there, everything else is built upon. He's the foundation. Leading to Sahasrara, true enlightenment. And devotees. Galit Baba always showed the love he had for his parents. My dear people, what love do you have for your mother and your father? Devotees, I'll give you a real life incident now. And I'll conclude you. I don't know, it's my clock that runs fast. I don't know why. I'll have to bring change and watch and bring a next one tomorrow. Every 5 minutes, you'll give me 1 minute only. So let me just give you an incident, devotee. There's so much to say. A man wanted to marry his daughter. And devotee, she was told, if you want to get your daughter married and things not happen, worship Lord Ganesh. And the bhajan said that, you know. Bhajan ko putra dika nidhan ko maya and all these different things he says. So devotees, he said, Ganesh, are you okay? Why go worship Lord Ganesh? So devotee, the man is, Baba gave a little murti to worship. He's so angry. He's so anti-Ganesh. When Baba gone, he went and pelted him well. He treated him well. Devotees. Somebody proposed to the daughter. The Ganesh Murti treated him well. Shortly after, the marriage ceremony took place. They call it a shotgun marriage. Yeah, what kind of? Think that hit him back half an hour. And don't let you take time and make sure you understand and everything is up to mark. The devotees, when the ceremony started and the fire was lit, the whole place got a fire. The man worried, when I think of this, I supposed to marry my daughter. She's supposed to go wrong in fire, but the fire went wrong all of them, all of them. How come this happened? This is a real starting of Swami Shivananda Festival of India. This is a great Swami who was a medical doctor until the yoga and meditation. He led the Divine Life Society. Devotees, the man is crying, the wife is giving the daughter, the whole said, Daddy, what kind of wedding, what kind of preparation is this? You did a marriage or a funeral? You had a roast all of your life and kill all of me? You couldn't take it. The Baba appeared again. You sad, fire, problem, pressure. You know what caused that? You have to go back and that same multi actually well, go down there and bring it back. Devotees, poor fella, they are no laden up. They tie on a rope table. And he went down there. You see, I said before, the same mouth that puts in trouble, the same mouth that takes care, the same hand used to hit and hurt and harm, same hand you have to help and heal one day, you know. Devotee, they lower him down. Had a snake here, mine. It had frog here, mine. He searched and looked for Ghanaian Murti. He found it. He said, put me up, Father. Put him up. Why the Murti? Put it up. His Baba said, what worship Ghanaian Baba now? And he wrote in how he worship Ghanaian Bhagwan, I don't have to tell you. And why he began to worship Ghanaian Bhagwan, the rain started to fall, bucket and drop at the sea. So heavy, it out of all the fire. And then the Baba said, you have done well. You have worshipped Lord Ganesh. Now, continue the marriage ceremony. That happened in India. Devotees, there are many, many things. I recall a few years ago, every time I go anywhere, I'll tell people, tell me your incidents, tell me what had happened with you and Lord Ganesh. I want to make another Quran with present day situations and have over 10 already. Can we get one? All right, you answer, okay. When you get it, booking, what do you do? I still feel the day one. Devotee, this fella had a dream. And he dreamed that he was in a glass case. No air, he began to suffocate. And devotee, he suffocated, suffocated. And Hanuman Baba appeared. He begged Hanumanji to release him. Devotee, Hanuman said yes. But remember, Pratham Pooj Ganapati Deva. Pratham Pooj. You first have to worship Lord Ganesh. When you please him, then I will do the rest. And he began to glorify Lord Ganesh. And he both did glorify Lord Ganesh. Hanuman Baba hit the cage one more down. It burst open. And he was free. You know what he did? He gave a temple. He gave a murti to a temple. And in South Trinidad, I won't tell you no more. It happened in South Trinidad. The devotees, I could go on and on and on like the energizer battery. But I have to stop here. I pray, my Lord Ganesh, bless us abundantly. Start worshipping him in a very sincere way. Boli Sri Gajanana Swami Ki. Now, how are we involved in the devotees? We can sing so many things, but I will just sing this. You know, I sat one day and said, why I can't make up a little something about Ganesh? So here I made up a little something about Ganesh. And you know what? He had accepted it. Very simple. I use a tune by Lord. A very simple words. Deus. While your father offering the many devotees, I just want to share quickly this with you. There are a number of mantras dedicated to Lord Ganesh. I'm prepared to give you a copy of it. Devotees, if you want to stop other people from harming you, what mantra you have to say? If you wish to destroy enemies and hatred and ego, what mantra you have to say? If you want to run away evil, there's a mantra from Lord Ganesh that you can say. And here's a nice one. If you want to attract people to you, but for good reason, even for job, marriage, there's a mantra to say. If you want wealth, there's a mantra that can be said. If you want enlightenment, liberation, there's also a mantra I have here. If you want to start anything, there's a mantra to say. If your life has been messed up and you want to rectify, there's a mantra to say. If you wish to remove obstacles, there's a mantra that can be said. However, the catch is this. The mantra which I have here, if you can get it afterwards, you have to say with purity, sincerity and devotion. You have to do it regularly for 48 days at the same time and the same place. I agree to the Lord Ganesh. Bowling Sri Gajanan Swami Ki Ganapati Arti. Sapun Karahuja. Please all stand. Om Jai Gauri Nandan Prabhu
Thank you. शुभ वस्तु कल्याण वस्तु आपको धन्यवाद सज्जा शिवा आपको कही चाहिए।
Have your seat, have your altar, present of one child, and please, I will prepare for all. Partake of the meal, give your blessing to the Brazilian family. Have a safe journey back home. I'll come on tomorrow, but then you will conclude. Let's bring it to a wonderful conclusion. Devotees, today once again we have some wonderful devotees joining us in the glorification. I don't recall the temple name. Shri Shakti Mandir from your area, not far from here. So when it's a blessing to all the members of the Mandir team, I glorify the Lord, join with us once again. So devotees, until tomorrow, see you.
Thank you.